board meetings this week seemed to me to be all over the place. On Monday, we heard about the Ten Commandments from the book of Leviticus. Then on Tuesday, the reading was from Isaiah, telling us that God's word will not return to him without accomplishing his purpose. Some could take that as referring to the Ten Commandments that we heard on the previous day. Then on Wednesday, we heard from the book of the prophet Jonah, and how the Ninevites repented when they were threatened with destruction by the Lord. So, we can take that there is forgiveness and salvation by turning back to the ways of the Lord. And then yesterday, the reading was from the book of Esther, and we were left with her words, "Save us from the hand of our enemies. Turn our mourning into gladness, and our sorrows into wholeness." That awaits us when we turn from our sinful ways. And today, our reading is from Ezekiel, who promises exactly that, by turning from our sinful ways, we will surely live. But if we turn to sin, we shall die. Tomorrow, the reading is from the book of Deuteronomy, which takes our first week of Lent to an end. We will hear that God makes a covenant with us and declares that we are to walk in his ways and to keep his statutes, commandments, and decrees, and to hearken to his voice. At first, I was confused about this skipping around through the Bible, but now it makes more sense as we begin our first week of the journey in Lent. We are to remember our salvation history and the promise of God that we are to be his people and he will be our God. Through thick and thin, through good times and bad, through sorrow and gladness, through life and through death. Sometimes we may think that God's ways are not fair because we want what we want, regardless of who else might be affected by our demands. I remember a time when I was so sure in my self-righteousness that someone in a position of authority was acting in an abusive manner towards their employees. So I went to their boss, presented the situation to them. They chose not to do anything about it. So I went further up the line and presented the situation to the higher up, and they assured me that something would be done. I waited and waited, and nothing changed. The abusive behavior continued. I developed a resentment toward those in authority and held a grudge against them for years. Then a situation presented itself when I realized that I was hurting myself and the bigger organization by holding on to my resentment. I went to the one whom I felt had betrayed me and apologized for holding on to my hurt and anger and asked for forgiveness. The person had not even realized that they had not gotten back to me to explain why things played out the way they did, and asked for my forgiveness that they had not responded to my appeal for justice. God could see what was the bigger picture and what was happening in the lives of all those concerned. I could only see a small piece of the picture. The air was cleared, and I had my peace restored. I had lived for years with a burden on my heart, and it could have been lifted if I had gone to a person and been reconciled. God's ways are much more fair than our mind. Thank God for that. This first week of Lent, let us let go of hurts and petty